reproduction and modification in plants. Learning objectives. After studying this lesson, students will be able to understand how a flower becomes a fruit with seed through pollination and fertilization. Acquire knowledge about pollination and pollinators. Differentiate self-pollination and cross-pollination in plants. Know about the modification of root, stem and leaves. Understand how these modifications are useful to animal and human being. Reproduction. The process by which plants and animals produce young ones and increase their number is known as reproduction. Sexual reproduction. Reproduction with the seed are called as sexual reproduction. For example, watermelon plant is produced from that seed. Asexual reproduction. Reproduction without seed are called as asexual reproduction. For example, potato plant is reproduced from the stem tuber, which is vegetative part. Vegetative and reproductive organ. Flowering plants have root, stem and leaves. They are called vegetative organs. Flowers, fruit and seeds in plant are called reproductive organs. Seed is produced from a flower by the process of pollination and fertilization. This is known as sexual reproduction. Plant and reproductive part. Mango reproduce through seed. Potato reproduce through stem. Banana reproduce through stem. Tamarind reproduce through seed. Rose reproduce through layering. Mustard reproduce through seed. Coriander reproduce through seed. Moringa reproduce through stem. Pumpkin reproduce through seed. Radish reproduce through root. Cut at slant, parent plant, by blade cutting. The cutting part grow into a new plant. Radish store food in root and it have buds. From that buds it reproduce. Parts of flower. Green leaf like structure present as an outermost layer is called a sepal. This outermost ring of sepal is known as calyx. Petals are attractive, brightly colored, sweet scented and attract the insect. This ring of petals together is called corolla. The male reproductive parts of a flower is androecium. It contains stamen, filament and pollen sac. The female reproductive part is gynoecium. It contains ovary, style and stigma. Common flower parts. Stigma, style, ovary, pistil. Anther and filament form stamen. Petal, sepal. Types of flowers. Complete flowers. If all the four whorls, calyx, corolla, stamens and pistil are present, then it is called as complete flower. Complete flowers are bisexual flowers. Incomplete flower. If any of these four corals is missing, then it is called as incomplete flower. Incomplete flowers are unisexual flowers. There are two types of unisexual flowers, male flowers and female flower. The flowers with androecium and without gynoecium is called as male flower. and the one with gynoecium and without androecium is known as female flower. Bisexual and unisexual flower. The bisexual flower has androecium and gynoecium. Unisexual flowers contains only gynoecium. Inflorescence. Sunflower is not a single flower. It is a group of flowers clusters together. A group of flowers arranged together is called inflorescence. Tridax procumbens looks like a single flower, but it is an inflorescence. Leaf juice of this plant is used to cure wounds and cut. Pollination. The process by which pollen grains reach stigma is called as pollination. The flower that receives pollen grains is called pollinated flower, while one that did not receive pollen grain is called as unpollinated flowers. Parts of the flowers: pollen grains, pollen transferred through the pollinator bee, the pollen falls on the stigma, ovary, ovule. Artificial pollination and natural pollination. We transfer the pollen grains from male flower to the female flower. This is called as artificial pollination. We transfer the pollen grains. Naturally, pollen grains reach the stigma of the flowers by pollinating agent like bee is called as natural pollination. Self-pollination and cross-pollination. Self-pollination. Pollen grains are transferred from the anther to the stigma of the same flower or the another flower of the same plant. Cross-pollination. Pollen grains are transferred from anther of one flower to stigma of another flower of the same kind or different plant. Plants do not need to produce pollen grains in a large quantity for self-pollination. Plants need to produce pollen grains in large quantities to increase the chance of pollination. It does not produce changes in the characteristics of new plants. Cross-pollination does introduce variations in the characteristics of new plants. Self-pollination and cross-pollination. The pollen grain transfer from one flower to another flower of the same plant, that is called as self-pollination. The pollen grains transfer from one plant to another plant, that is called as cross-pollination. Pollinators. The agents that are helping in pollination are called pollinators. Insect, wind, water and animal are pollinators. Beans, Fabaceae and tomatoes, Solanaceae. This is a family name. Bean is a family of Fabaceae. Tomato is a family of Solanaceae. Commonly self-pollinate. Plants such as apples, plums, strawberries, pumpkins use insect for cross-pollination. Fertilization. Male gamete fuses with the female gamete to form zygote. This process is known as fertilization. Parts of the picture: stigma, style, ovary, ovule. Pollen grains fall on the stigma and grow as a pollen tube. The pollen tube carry the pollen nucleus. The pollen nucleus fuse with egg cells and form zygote. Longitudinal section of ovary. Parts of the picture: style, monotelphous, staminal tube, petal, point where petals joins stamen tube, sepals, superior ovary with axil placentation. Placentation used to fix the ovule into the flower. Epicalyx. The transverse section of ovary. Lobulidia. Campanulidia. Post-fertilization changes. The changes taking place in a flower after fertilization are said to as post-fertilization changes. Calyx sometimes persist with fruits. Petals wither or fall off. Antroecium fall off. Pistil remain and develop into a fruit. Style and stigma fall off. Ovary enlarges to store food materials and develops into a fruit. Ovules present inside the ovary develops into seed. The world's largest and heaviest seed is the double coconut. Orchids have the smallest seed in the plant kingdom. Asexual reproduction. The production of new plants without the involvement of pollination and fertilization is known as asexual reproduction. Types of asexual reproduction. Vegetative propagation, budding, fragmentation, spore formation. Vegetative propagation. Reproduction through vegetative parts like roots, stem, leaves are called as vegetative reproduction. In potato, shoot arise from eyes. Sugarcane and yam also grow like this. Budding. Yeast produces a small protuberance which gradually grow and detach from the parent cell. This process is called budding. First cell is the parent cell. It contains vacuoles and nucleus. Vacuoles elongated and separated. Emerging bud. Movement of nucleus. Bud is separated from parent cell and grow as a new cell. Fragmentation. Spirochaera is a filamentous algae. When it matures, the filaments divide into species. Each fragments will grow into a new filament. This process is known as fragmentation. Spore formation. During unfavorable condition, non-flowering plants like algae, fungi, moss, and fans produce spores. They germinate into a new plant when the favorable condition return. Bread mold, enlarged mycelium, spore-producing structure. In the spore-producing structure, gills is present. Pores in the gills of the mushroom help it to reproduce. Function of plant part. Roots evolve primarily to anchor the plant and also to absorb water and mineral nutrients from the soil. Leaves are adapted to optimize photosynthesis. Stems evolve to reach out to sunlight and also to conduct water from roots to leaves. Modification. In some plants, root, stem, and leaves change their shape and structure to perform special function like storage of food, mechanical support, production, and other vital function. This is known as modification. Modification. Cacti leaves are modified into spines, an adaptation to reduce transpiration. Photosynthesis is performed by the stem part of the plant. This is example for modification. modification of root, roots for storage. Example, tape root of radish, roots for mechanical support, prop roots of banyan tree, tilt root of sugar cane, climbing roots in beetle, breathing roots or respiratory roots, roots of avicenna. Roots for storage, radish, turnip, beetroot and carrot are store the food produced by them in taproot. Taproot of the radish is in the shape of spindle, swollen in the middle and tapering at both end. Such type of modified roots are called spindle-shaped root. Root for mechanical support. Prop roots grow vertically from horizontal branches of a banyan tree. In sugarcane and maize, advantageous roots arise from the nodes in cluster at the base of the stem. These roots are called stilt roots, which give additional support. In beetle and black pepper, nodes or internodes bear roots which help in climbing. Breathing roots are respiratory roots. Avicennia is a tree which grows in mangroves and swamps. They have roots which are seen above the crown for the purpose of gaseous exchange. These roots are erect, peck-like structure with numerous pores through which air circulates. These roots are called breathing roots or nematopores. Haustorial roots are sucking roots. Huskuta, a parasite plant, climb the trees and other vegetation and use the haustorial roots to penetrate the tissue of the host plant and suck nutrients from them. They are usually found in parasitic plants that depend on the host plants for nutrients. Epiphytic roots. Vanda is an epiphytic plant which grow on trees. The velamen tissue present in the epiphytic root absorbs moisture to perform photosynthesis. Modification of stem. Type of modification of stem. Aerial modification, phylloclads. Subaerial modifications are divided into four types: runner, stolon, sucker, offset. Underground modifications are divided into four types: rhizome, comb, tuber, bulb. Aerial modification. Example, phylloclads. What is phylloclads? To reduce transpiration, cactus has a thick stem which does most of the food production through photosynthesis, and the leaves are reduced to small pines with less surface area. This type of modification is called as phylloclads. Subaerial modification, runner. The stem, which grows laterally on the surface of the soil, breaks up to produce roots where it touches the ground to give rise to a new plant. Example, centella, ballarai. Parts of the picture, lamina, petioles, flower, stolon, roots, stem, root. Plant, scientific name is Centella asiatica. Subaerial modification, stolon. Stolon is a slender branch of the stem that grows upwards to some distance and then bend towards the ground. Upon touching the ground, it gives rise to a new plant. Example, wild strawberry. Subaerial modification, sucker. Sucker is a short and weak lateral branch that grow diagonally upwards and directly give rise to a new shoot. Example, chrysanthemum and mentha. Subperial modification, offset. An offset is a short and thick branch that arises from the axial part of a leaf. It has thick internodes. It produces a tuft of leaves and cluster of small roots below. Example, Eigonia. In underground modification, in underground modified stem, whole stem is buried under the ground and it has a definite growth. Usually, stem grows above the ground, but there are some stems that grow under the ground to store food. These underground stems swell and become thick. Underground modification, rhizome. It is an underground thick stem with nodes and internodes with scale leaves at the nodes. It grows horizontally and has an irregular shape. Rhizome have buds. It gives rise to new stem and leaves. Example, ginger and turmeric. Underground modification, home. This underground stem is round in shape and flat at the top and bottom. It is a condensed form of rhizome and bears one or more buds in the axil of scale leaves. Daughter plants arise from their buds. Example, Colocasia. Underground modification, tuber. It is an enlarged spherical underground stem that stores food. It has many dormant buds on its surface known as eyes. If we plant a part of tuber with a bud, it grows into a new plant. Example, potato. Underground modification, bulb. The upper part of the stem has terminal bud and it is covered by many scale leaves. The inner fleshy leaves store food as seen in garlic and onion. Modification of leaves, spines. Leaves are reduced to spines and the stem is modified into green succulent part to perform photosynthesis. Example, Opuntia. Modification of leaf, tendrils. In climbers, the leaf of plants are modified into elongated structure to help the plant climb efficiently. Gloriosa superba. Leaf tips are modified into tendrils. Pisum sativum. Terminal leaflets are modified into tendrils. Modification of leaf, pyloclades. Modification of leaf, pylodes. In Acacia, auriculiformis petioles expand to form leaf-like structure. They carry out the function of leaf photosynthesis. Acacia. Modification of leaf, traps. Plants that grow in nitrogen deficient places adapt themselves well to get it. In Nepenthes, the leaves are modified into a flask-like structure which is used to attract insects. The inner wall of the leaf secrete digestive enzymes that helps to digest the insect and extract the nitrogen needed for the plant. Thank you.